Hey, Dr. C with you. Let's talk about melatonin and thyroid. So what's the connection? Well, it turns out that they are connected in some pretty deep ways, and melatonin has big relevance to too much or too little thyroid hormone, and also vice versa. So let's make sense out of these two hormones and their implications and how they can be affecting your overall health. So for starters, what is melatonin? Where does it come from? Well, this is a hormone, and it's a peptide hormone, which means it's a chain of amino acids. Hormones come in two big categories. There's peptides and steroids. So peptides are amino acid chains. Steroids are modified versions of cholesterol. General rule of thumb, peptides come from waist up. So pancreas, thyroid, hypothalamus, pituitary, and also the pineal gland. And the pineal gland is the main source of melatonin in the body. But it turns out it's not the only source. It's also made by the thyroid gland. The main role of melatonin is to start the whole sleep process. So it doesn't preserve sleep throughout the night, but it initiates the events that cause us to wind down and go into sleep. And as such, there's a seesaw relationship between it and cortisol. So when there's a healthy daily circadian rhythm, cortisol is high in the morning, and that pushes down the last remnants of melatonin. And then as cortisol drops off in the afternoon and the evening, that allows melatonin to start creeping up and elevating to its nighttime levels. So the timing of this is really the timing of our sleep. Now the connection here is that melatonin itself has positive effects upon thyroid function. It also affects sleep, you know, general health, and many other relevant symptoms. What's interesting, though, is that there's popular usage of it in higher dosages. And there's the amounts that our body makes, and there's amounts that we can absorb from supplements. And it turns out that the higher doses that we can absorb, they can actually worsen autoimmunity. They can have adverse effects, and they can have some safety problems. These have gotten a lot more attention as of late. There's a large recent study showing just that, that common over-the-counter doses of melatonin may worsen autoimmune responses and may worsen internal quality of sleep. Now, why would this happen? You know, why would the hormone that makes you sleep make you not sleep as well? So this comes down to a lot of ways in which the body is not intuitive, but when you understand it more deeply, it makes sense. So the body is expecting a certain amount of melatonin, and that's controlled in terms of how much comes out from the gland into the bloodstream, but it's also controlled in terms of how the cells respond to melatonin. If you ever get a whopping amount of a hormone, your body makes itself numb to it, and it resists that. So there's specific receptors in the cells that absorb melatonin itself, and when there's huge amounts in your body, these receptors diminish. That means your cells get fewer of them, and the ones you have become less active. This whole process is called receptor downregulation, and it's one of the many ways that hormones can do the opposite of what you think they would do. So what happens if your body gets numb to melatonin? Well, you don't sleep well. You can actually have a hard time getting to sleep and a hard time staying asleep throughout the night. So even though melatonin is important, and the body needs it for stopping free radicals, for lowering our risk for cancers, for cutting our risk of premature aging, when we get high amounts of it, we stop all of that. We can worsen all of those things. And this is where we've got to separate speculation from observation. You know, we can see that people who run low in melatonin have more health problems. And therefore, it's easy to speculate that if you give the person a whopping dose of melatonin, you can prevent or reverse those same problems. But now we're seeing the exact opposite can occur. If you give too much, you can worsen those problems because you make the body resistant to that. So how can it be helpful? How can it be useful? Well, what we're seeing is that how much we make can be complemented by small amounts. We can get some from our diet, and we can consume small amounts in supplementation. It turns out that in supplementation, if melatonin hits the bloodstream more quickly and it's in tiny amounts, it's useful and it causes us to make more by ourselves. if it's delayed over a long period of time, that's not what your body would do by itself. Your body doesn't release a large amount for long periods of time. So delayed release versions of melatonin seem to work against our own output. And then high doses do as well. So let's get down to detail here. What are we talking about for high doses and low doses? It's going to freak you guys out if you've taken this before. So the higher doses that cause these issues are doses in the range of a milligram and greater. A milligram is the same as 1,000 micrograms. And I think the most common potencies we see in the market now are between 5 and 20 milligrams, or 5 and 20,000 micrograms. So these things can work. They can cause someone to get knocked out and, you know, put to sleep for a while. And what happens in over-the-counter supplements is that it's just like supersize me, you know, from like McDonald's or the big swigs, the big gulps or whatever. There's this idea that the consumers demand more, like more is always better, and that products are made to fill that thought. So these companies compete and they want to show who has the highest dose of melatonin. So now there's this arms race going on, and we commonly see 10, 20 or more milligrams in products. But there's so much research showing that the most effective doses are tiny fractions of that. So, and this becomes even more pronounced as we age. Once we move past 40 years of age, all these things that I said are just like even more significant and even more pronounced. So somewhere between 100 and 200 micrograms seems to be the sweet spot. If we talked about that in terms of milligrams, that would be 0.1 to 0.2 milligrams. So a tiny amount. And this is the thing with hormones and nutrients, their effects are almost never linear. It's almost never the case that if a little bit does a little bit, a lot does a lot. It just doesn't work that way in living systems. Living systems are complex. We very commonly see inverse U-shaped curves, meaning that tiny doses do things very different from high doses or in between doses. And in the case of melatonin, the most effective doses appear to be about 100 to 200 micrograms for adults. Now, I kept seeing these papers and I kept hearing people ask about their sleep and saying how melatonin would help them, but not always work, or it gave them weird dreams, or they needed to take it every night. And the more I saw about this and the more studies came out, they showed that it can work short term, but it's not safe and it's not effective for long term. And the problem is that it takes away your body's own output. It makes your body less able to make the amounts that it would make on its own. But it's not a problem with melatonin that's inherent. It's only a dose-related problem. So the small doses, they can help. They can be safe. They can be effective. They can help one's own output. They can even be used longer term if need be. There's no big drawbacks to that. So all this inspired me to make a new product, and I coined the term thyrotonin. And that's just a portmanteau, like a contracture between thyroid and melatonin. The thyroid makes melatonin. Those with thyroid disease have different requirements for melatonin and different effects from melatonin. So I made this in a 100 microgram capsule. And the usage is 1 to 2 capsules about 30 minutes before bed on an empty stomach. So that's simple. And that can be used on a regular basis if need be. Few need it regularly. Between its effects and sleep hygiene tips, most can get good quality sleep back again. For those who are resetting their schedule, this can also work for traveling issues and jet lag. In those cases, the dose is 3 of those capsules, and same thing, half an hour before sleep and on an empty stomach. But this is a great opportunity. So melatonin can help. It can safely lower the body's free radical load, help the immune system, improve sleep, give all those benefits, improve thyroid function. But it's a matter of safe dosing. This is a case to where smaller amounts simply work better. They work with the body. They don't overwhelm the body. They don't fight it. They don't block it. All right, Dr. C with you. Take great care of yourself. We'll talk again really soon.